to a manpower shortage it blames on missed and delayed pickups.
ABC 7's Shannon Clow was at the theater today talking to people willing to take out the trash themselves.
Well, we want to show you how easy this is. Take a look. You just pull up right here. They'll take your trash, load it up into this truck right here. And I've been talking with people taking advantage of this service. They say they're happy to have it here. Jonathan Bacon's trash was clogging up his neighborhood.
I had a couple toilets that I'd replaced that were sitting in my front yard for almost a month.
That's why he came here to Waste Pro's pickup spot at Cultural Park Theater, flushing those views away.
They were becoming a fixture in the neighborhoods.
Those toilets aren't the only overflow of trash in Cape Coral.
Just like down Hancock Bridge, I drove down there a week or so ago, and there's couches and mattresses and stuff all up and down the road.
How it works is Waste Pro should pick up bulk items one day after your scheduled pickup, but they admit they're way behind because they're understaffed. That's why people are here today.
Well, because it wasn't being picked up at the house.
For weeks, his debris sat on his lawn.
My concern is that it was killing the grass in the front yard.
To keep his grass growing, Cape Coral officials are holding Waste Pro accountable. At tomorrow's council meeting, Waste Pro needs a plan on more ways they're improving.
Well, yeah, I'd prefer they came to the house, sure, but, you know.
But on a rainy day like today, he's looking on the bright side.
Just try to be, understanding and compassionate. You know, all businesses, all peoples are going through hard times.
In Cape Coral, Shannon Clow, ABC 7.